I'd like to share my victory. Is that okay?
Yes.
So, October 2015, I was diagnosed with diabetes. And it was high. My A1C, for those of you who know what A1C is, it's the level of your diabetes. It was above 10. My glucose level was 535. So I went to the, how I got to know this was my body wasn't functioning the way that I wanted it to. I felt tired. Climbing stairs was like climbing Mount Everest. I was out of breath. I was peeing all the time. My thoughts were not clear. So I went to the doctor who did some tests. And the next day, she calls me early in the morning, like 5 o'clock in the morning. She says, get to the emergency room right now. And I tell her no. Because I just started a new job. It was my first day and I could not leave. And she says, yes, you can. Your kidneys are failing you as we speak. That's not good. You could go into a coma at any second. That's not good. You can leave your job. I suggest you do it now. Okay. I went to the doctor. They hooked me up to, gave me some fluids, and, you know, did the doctor stuff. But as I was laying there in the hospital, it became very clear to me I had to make a choice, whether I wanted to live or die. And I could actually feel my life force leaving my body. That's how this experience was for me. And I prayed, and I chose to live. I chose to live. Now you see, the year before, I've been having, up until that point, I've had an amazing year. I moved to Spain, I went to school in Spain. I studied music technology and innovation there at Berklee College of Music, one of the top colleges for music. Got my master's degree, and I thought my life was about to take off. And my thoughts were, okay, we're gonna move to Berlin, we're gonna stay in Spain, we're gonna, you know, but I came back home, and my body was not cooperating with what I was thinking. I live currently at Franklin and Pacific. For those of you who are regular members, you know that was our old spot. I live in that building upstairs. Every Sunday, I would come down on my way to another church, and I would hear music that was so close to my heart. You see, like Pastor Yolanda said, Pastor Greg and Yolanda and I are like brothers and sisters. I've known them for a long time. I also know this music very well. I used to teach this music in other communities. So this was something that I was needing at the time. One Sunday, as I'm passing by hearing the music, I stop on by. I go in and I say, wow, new faces. I don't know anybody except for the pastors. But it feels like home. So I'm going to stay with you. Each Sunday will come back. And for those of you who were there, I'd be singing in the congregation like I was on stage. And everybody would be like, you know. And then there was an opportunity to join the choir. And members of the congregation would ask me, you going to join the choir? They're like, no. You know, I like receiving. I like this experience. You sure you're not going to join the choir? Yeah. Then I thought about it. My experience of getting up in front of people and singing is the quickest way for me to heal. My brothers and sisters who sing with me are my angels. I remember talking to Pastor Greg and saying, you know, this is the case, I have diabetes, but I don't want you to hold me there. I want you to see me as healthy. And he said, for sure. Pastor Yolanda Greg and I would go out to lunch after we always spoke the truth with health. Okay, so I have been diagnosed with diabetes. I began to change my diet, no more sugar. And it wasn't a struggle because I found things that I liked to eat, you know. If I didn't like to eat, I'd eat. But I like to eat certain things, so let me go ahead and eat those healthy things that I like. That changed. But the most important thing that changed, and one of the most important tools that I can share from this experience to you, is my morning practice. How many people know what a morning practice is?
Yes.
A morning practice is prayer in the morning. It is meditation in the morning. It is aligning yourself with your higher self, with souls, before you do anything in the day. Anything. So what I did was a morning practice every day consistently. And my goal was not to get up for my morning practice unless I felt good. You know, I've been on this path for a little bit and have been challenged by these teachings. And I've come to the point where I know without a doubt that they work for me. If they work for me, guess what? They work for you. It's a science. So my morning practice, I would go deep and I would meditate and feel the energy and actually guide the energy to where I wasn't feeling good. And also imagine that the light was kind of transforming my body, my cells. And then the rest of my day was great. It became a fun process. My healing process was fun. It was not a struggle. I know who I am truly. The divine lives within me. And because the divine lives within me, the divine lives within you. I had so many angels around me holding that truth for me. I want to thank you all that was there for me on that journey. So I went to the doctor about 4 weeks ago. She goes, I've been waiting to see you all day. I go, why? She was like, come here. I've been telling all my colleagues. I've been sharing this. I was like, okay. So she sits me down at the computer. She shows me this chart, right? And October 15th, my A1C was at 10, right? And then in four months, it's at 6. Well, what does that mean? She goes, that means you're a superstar. For those of you who don't know, 6, below a 6, you don't have diabetes. Right? She was surprised. I was not. I hope that my story, my victory, my love, inspires somebody. I hope that you take my words and use them and apply them in your life. They're not just for me. I know that my journey was to share, really. And that's what my life